So the third method I'm trying to tell you is the Tanaka and Johnson method. Now, initially we had, in the radiographic method, we had the issue of the radiograph, because radiograph has to be present, and the radiograph has the issue of the rotated teeth, issue of radiography in the canine area, and rotation of the teeth are the issues. In the Moyles, the issue is the difficulty of application in our population, and the presence of the chart available for you for doing the analysis. Here, in the Tanaka and Johnson method, all the issues of the previous methodologies have been resolved. In the Tanaka and Johnson, they have developed a coefficient. I'm not going into the detail how they have concluded these coefficient, but how you will use this method, we are just going to discuss it. For maxilla, the coefficient is 11. For mandible, the coefficient is 10.5. Okay, so this again is a three-step process, and how you will come to know the missing data for doing the analysis. What was the missing data? What is the mesodistal width of 3, 4, and 5? That is required to memorize. Before you proceed any further, you need to memorize the coefficient. For the maxilla is 11, for the mandible is 10.5. Got it? How do we perform the Tanaka and Johnson method? First of all, we do measure the mesiodistal width of lower incisors and lateral incisor. This is the first step. You measured the mesiodistal width of the lower incisors and lower lateral incisor. The first step is the measurement of the mesiodistal width of the central and right lateral. Let's say the value is 24 millimeter, just for the sake of it. Then the second step, you will divide whatsoever is the value by 2. By 2, basically you want to take the half of it, half-sided. Okay, so that's why you make it half side of the, so first you take the average of the lower central lateral, then you take the half. Let's say, make it, if the value was 24, make it like 12, or we can have a x. You will divide the x value by 2. Okay, so whatsoever, the third step is this, whatsoever is the answer, 12, for example, 12 is the answer, you will add the coefficient. What was the coefficient for the maxilla? 11. You would add 11, and then you will get to know the mesiodistal width of upper 3, 4, and 5. For example, in the example I said the value was 24. So if you had 24 is the mesiodistal width of the lower central lateral incisor, then half of it is 12, and in the 12 you are going to add in the third step as the coefficient of the 11. This will give you the value of 3, 4, and 5. So what is the sum of 11 and 12? 23. So 23 is the mesiodistal width of 3, 4, 5. I am just giving you a clue. What is the average mesiodistal width of the one premolar? 7. The average mesiodistal width of 5 is 7. The average mesiodistal width of the canine is 3. So your answer is 22. So your answer of this Tanaka and Johnson should be vary around this value. It should not be like that 48, 53, 64, 71, or 11, 12, 6. The answer logically, because the mesiodistal width of 5 is 7 on an average population, the mesiodistal width of the 4 on average population is 7, the mean distal width of the canine in the average population is 8. So your answer should be around 22. So what are the three steps of the Tanaka and Johnson? First of all, you will measure the mean distal width of the lower incisors. Then you will divide it by 2, 12. And in the 12, you will be adding the coefficient. If you want to measure the mean distal width of the upper, you will add 11. If you want the mean distal width of the lower, that would be 10.5. If your answer is around 22, this makes sense that you are proceeding logically. So now, quickly revising the three steps, measure the mean distal width of the lower incisors, divide it by 2, add the coefficient, and this will tell you the half side. Now you want to multiply it by 2. Why you want it to multiply by 2? For the whole hours, because you want to measure the left and the right side. You want to measure both the sides.